Hey, Rhonda Rosand here today, CPA, Advanced Certified QuickBooks Pro Advisor with new business directions, and I've got a sample file of QuickBooks open here for you. I'm going to show you how to use the same name on different lists in QuickBooks. This is a sample file, QuickBooks 2018. I see gyrations of this all the time, people trying to have a vendor and an employee with the same name on different lists, and QuickBooks won't let you do that. So let's talk about the proper way to do this instead of all these gyrations I see clients doing with last name first, first name last, middle initial, no middle initial, etc., etc. Let's start with the employee list. We have Dan T. Miller. He's an employee. If I go to the vendor center in QuickBooks and I type in Miller, comma, Dan, I've got the same guy. If I try to edit his name and put a T on the end of this, I'm going to get an error message from QuickBooks telling me that this name is already in use in the employee center. You can't use the same name on more than one list, da 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 da. Well, that's a problem. I've got a guy, he's an employee, he needs a W-2, he also gets paid subcontractor wages, and he needs a 1099, he needs to have his legal name on both lists. QuickBooks isn't going to let me make it the same name. Here's what you do. You use the squiggly brackets. Now, you can call them what you want. They're braces, curly brackets, French brackets, Scottish brackets. I call them the official term of squiggly brackets. They're on your keyboard to the right of the P. When you hit the shift key and choose the square brackets, you get a squiggly bracket. And if you use that, and in that squiggly bracket, you put a V for vendor on the vendor of Miller, Dan T, then it will accept that. And the V shows up here. It will not show up on the 1099 because anything inside of squiggly brackets is invisible. So now I can go over here to the employee center. I can do the same thing here. I can edit Dan T. Miller on the end of him in squiggly brackets, put an E for employee, and then I can say, okay, I have Dan T. Miller as an employee. I have Miller Dan T as a vendor, and when I go to write a check and I start with Mr. Miller, I can see whether I am picking the vendor or the employee, and I don't need to go through all these fancy gyrations to determine, okay, who is it? What is it that I'm looking at? Am I on the vendor list? Am I on the employee list? Which one is it? So that takes care of that. And you can also add Mr. Miller to the customer list. So if we go into the customer list and add a new customer and put Dan T. Miller, squiggly bracket, C, squiggly bracket closed, I now have three Dan T. Millers on three separate lists, and it's all good with QuickBooks with no error message. If you have any questions about QuickBooks or need assistance, please start with our website at newbusinessdirections.com. If we can help with your organizing your chaos or streamlining the process, please give us a call. It's okay. We can help.